Hey, what's going on, everyone? Doorstep's Gaming here. Welcome back to the channel. I know we said in our last video that this would be the last one in this space, but we actually had a cool product come in we want to check out before we moved over to the new space. So today we're going to be taking a look at something Deepcool just sent us, their AS500 cooler. It's actually a pretty nice little cooler with some nice RGB and even better cooling performance from what they're telling us. So we're going to test that out today. So we're going to be doing an all Deepcool build here because we'll have the new AS500 to test. You guys have seen us use the MF120 GT fans here in the past, and we're actually going to be putting these in their CL500 case. So we're going to dive into building this and then test the performance of this new AS500 from Deepcool. As far as our other parts today, a quick run over those. Our usual Aorus V550 Pro. We'll be using some M.2s we already have installed there that we have our drives on, and then some stuff over from Team, actually taking a look at their Delta RGB kits. We'll be doing 32 gigs of that today. And then our normal Aorus 2070 Super. Again, comment down below if you guys have been able to find any 3080s in stock yet. We're still looking. Hopefully we can get our hands on one of those pretty quick. But everything we've been looking at and notifying for still runs out of stock pretty fast, even as soon as we get the notify for it. And then for our power supply today, we have a Focus GX750 from Seasonic. So we'll jump into building this one today. We figured we'd do one more build in this space since it is Spooktober. So again, guys, happy Halloween on that. So we might do a little Halloween theme around this one too. So if you like Halloween theme PCs, you can check out our last video where we actually did a Halloween theme on that one as well. But the main focus today is going to be diving into this AS500 cooler and testing the performance of that. So let's go.
Before we hop into today's video, we want to thank our sponsor Deepcool and their new Castle 360 EX RGB AO, available in 240 and 360 millimeter, as well as their MF120 GT ARGB fans. To learn more about how Deepcool can upgrade your system, check the sponsor link in the description below.
Before we jump in actually building this thing, let's actually unbox and take a closer look at the AS500. Like I said, this was kind of a surprise show up from Deepcool. We didn't know it was actually fully launching yet, but it has fully launched now. So we're gonna go and unbox it so you guys can see what all you get. We'll take a closer look at the cooler itself. Take it out of its packaging here. All right, so it looks like we have a box for mounting hardware, packed pretty nicely in there. And then we have the cooler itself. Looks like a single, what size fan is this here on the outside? Actually does not say. We'll have to double check that. I'll add that up to that. From the outside of the box here, looks like it's showing a total TDP of 220 watts. Now you guys, I'm pretty sure if you've dug into TDP, that not every company measures theirs the same. So that all can change a good bit. Let's see, looks like, oh, it has a 140 millimeter fan. Okay, so normal 140 size here, meant to fit everything from LGA 2066 and then AM4, of course. That's what we'll be using on it today. And then looks like for height clearance, it's 164 millimeters, PWM fan. Let's see, normal fluid dynamic bearing. Like I said, just reading off some of the specs here. And looks like fan speed are ranging anywhere between 500 and 1200 RPM. So it should stay pretty quiet too. And looks like we have an airflow of 70.81 CFM. So a decent amount of flow across the heatsink here. Looks like we're gonna be getting if these specs listed on the side of the box are true. Let's see, just for dimensions, if you're looking for a cooler like this in your case, let's see if we're taking a look at the front here. Looks like the, let's look at the bottom plate. It's going to be 43 millimeters. It's going to be 164 millimeters in height, like I said earlier, and then 142 millimeters across. So the biggest thing looks like here is going to be, you know, it still has a pretty deep fin sink here. Looks like we have a total of 5 heat pipes. It looks like it runs straight through the cold plate there. And then we looks like we have, mounting on the sides here, so just have the 2 mounting brackets on the side there. It looks like it'll be mounting to each side. And then, like I said, just a single 140 kind of pulling on this side towards the sink. And it looks like at the bottom here we have our cabling. So you have the PWM connector there, and then what looks like one of Deepcool's, if we can slide it out here where we can see it. And it looks like one of Deepcool's ARGB connectors. So looks like you'll, pretty sure there'll be a controller in here for that, since it's not a standard ARGB three pin. So like I said, it looks like you want to plug it into one of Deepcool's things. So if you are, you know, in our case, doing a full Deepcool build, that should make it a little easier. But taking a look at the top of the cooler here, looks like the only RGB we're going to be looking at, since it's not on the fan itself, it looks like it's around the top of the shroud. So it actually has a little clearer white. Yeah, it looks like it looks to be on both sides, a little clearer white kind of ring going around the top of this shroud here that's on the top of the fin stacks. So that's actually looks like what's going to be illuminating. And then looks like one of their, like I said, just 140 fans attached to the side of it there. So, I mean, looks like it's mainly going to be a decent performer for especially a smaller case. And we'll check definitely some, you know, RAM clearances. Because if you guys checked a few videos back, we actually did do a test with the CL500 and putting the new Arctic Freezer 50 in it that just launched not that long ago. So if you guys want to check out that video, we'll link it up at the top of the cards. If I remember to do that for you guys. But I actually did the Arctic Freezer 50 in that one, and the biggest issue we ran into with that was just some RAM clearance, because the it was 120 to 140 both on that fan set and push-pull, so the shroud of that fan kind of stuck out over the dimm slots a good bit. So we'll be checking that out today as we're building. But that just about goes over everything with the cooler itself. Open the box real quick just to be sure. Yeah, it looks like we have our looks like there is an adapter for, yeah, like I said, we have a regular SATA controller here. So if you're not using, or your motherboard doesn't have an ARGB pin, looks like you can connect it through SATA and then control it that way. Or there is an adapter here to connect it to an ARGB pin on your motherboard if you're not plugging it into a Deepcool ecosystem already, or your motherboard doesn't have a any kind of ARGB connectors. You can just use the SATA one that's included, or you can adapt it for you know, Gigabyte boards, MSI boards, such as those. Looks like we do have some extra clips here included. So maybe I'm assuming if you had to replace those, I'm guessing that you can mount one on the other side. Yeah, it looks like it could swing around. So if you did have one you wanted to set up on the opposite side of the sink, you could. And then we have our mounting hardware, looks like down here, for both AM4 and Intel brackets included in the kits, as well as the instruction manual, and they even include a bit of thermal paste, which that's always nice to see. All right, well, let's get this cleaned up and then we'll start building, come back and talk about the cooling performance. So let's go. Hope you guys enjoyed the little montage there. Let's hop into some quick benchmarks. We didn't have a whole lot of time to do a ton of benchmarks today. Like I said, mainly just did some CineBench testing. And as you can see here, like I said, we're at an ambient of 22.5C in our room. Under stock conditions, the 3600 with this cooler on it idled at 29C. And then we ran a stress test of about 30 minutes in CineBench R20, like I said, at stock. We averaged out around 65C
and then we came back and did a stress test and overclocked the 3600 to 4.3 gigahertz, and that bumped it up to about 72C after 30 minutes. Now, obviously, we did test a little bit of games as well. Like I said, we ran some Doom Eternal. Didn't have time to capture any footage of us playing, but obviously under gaming load, the temps weren't quite as high as this at all. Like I said, during our Doom Eternal test, we ran a mission for about 30 minutes. And like I said, let the case fully soak full. And like I said, we were only seeing temperatures of around 45 up to around 55 during, you know, heavy rendered areas. So definitely not quite as high as CineBench R20 here. But like I said, during a game, you're not really utilizing 100% of the CPU like you would a render test like CineBench R20. So keep that in mind when looking at these numbers. This is not during gaming. This is during a stress test. So that about concludes the thermal testing. Let's jump back out and finish this up. All right, guys, so that about wraps it up here with the AS500 cooler from Deepcool. Been a really solid performing cooler to work with here. Like I said, we had no issues, as you guys saw from the testing, on maintaining the temps well for this 3600, both stock and overclocked. Not a super high heat part to test this on, but we still wanted to get some data on it since we had a data on a previous air cooler that we tested as well. Biggest pros, I would say, for this cooler, its mounting is super simple. And like I said, because of the density of the heatsink and where the fans place, we had no issues with memory clearance. So we were able to populate all four dimm slots there with no issue. Other than that, like I said, it's super quiet. Like I said, we didn't do any decibel readings or anything like that, but with the 140 that's on the front here, it's whisper silent even running at 100%. Like I said, we actually hear more of the case fans than anything. And that's if we get right up on it. And even if we get right up on the cooler itself with that 140 spinning at full speed, you know, it's a max of 1200 RPM. So you still can hardly hear anything at all at 100%. So again, that about wraps it up, you guys. Appreciate you guys for stopping by the channel. Remember to subscribe. We do have more coming. We'll be taking a short break just for a little bit here because we'll be moving here in about another week and a half to our new setup, and then we'll have some time to set that up as well. We're still taking some suggestions, so if you guys have any ideas on how we should set up the new office space, so definitely feel free to comment down below if you have any ideas on that. Still kind of debating on what kind of desk setup we want to go with. Kind of debating back and forth between maybe doing a larger L-shaped desk, you know, having a spot for our main rig, and then off to the side have, you know, our project builds and stuff like that that we do for the Instagram and here on the YouTube. Like I said, if you guys do want to check us out on Instagram, we're over at Desktops Gaming. Feel free to give us a follow over there as well. We post all of the completed builds that we do on there, and then, you know, we shoot kind of longer form content here. So again, about wraps it up. You guys have a happy Halloween. Appreciate you for stopping by. Take it easy.